Hi everyone, can you give me a little thumbs up if you can hear me? And we go live in about 13 minutes. See you soon.
All the boys and girls on Christmas with no toys or love to share. All the hearts with empty wishes, and there's no one there to care. To everyone who ever dared.
Michelle, I feel your pain. I've got COVID too. So if you are coming to one of my pub quizzes on Wednesday or Thursday, I won't be there, but the quiz is still on. So hi, welcome to the quiz. If you've not played before, this is how you play. So there's an online entry form. Hopefully you've got that. I'm just gonna post it again in the chat if not. We do ask that you don't write answers in the chat. Yeah, get well soon, Michelle. Hi, Marie. You okay? And it's well worth filling that form in because I hope not, Jodie. It's all right, Lisa. If I get confused, that's why. Make mistakes. I mark it for you completely. And then post you the answers by email and, of course, a league table of scores so you know what you scored. It's out of 70 tonight and there's 65 questions. Not too Christmassy tonight because on Friday, of course, Christmas Eve, we've got the big one. And it is going to be a bit. Yeah, I don't feel great, Denise, to be honest. But it's more about missing work, you know. Oh no, Sean. It's like the illness quiz, isn't it? No, Amy's not got it, Anne. I'm just aching all over and you know. I'm not dying, you know, I'm all right. We do ask please that you don't Google any answers during the quiz. It's all a bit of fun and we have a little chat, as you can see. Hi Martin. But we do ask for a small donation for playing. And that's how we manage to keep running. That link is down there. Chuck a couple of quid and we call it the honesty box. So here we go. Oh, Halla, you had it. It is, isn't it? When was it? It was about 4 hours ago, I think. Right, so first question. First 12 are your picture round. All them monkeys and primates, and you've got to match them up. And this is question 13. So what does Cinderella's fairy godmother turn a pumpkin into? That's it. I tell you what, that's the only thing, because I do DJ and you know, stuff like that. Wiped out. So question 13, what does Cinderella's fairy godmother turn a pumpkin into? Now the quiz does start really easy and we get harder as we go. First half is a little bit more difficult. On to question 14. Who, according to the Bible, were the first people to visit Jesus? So who, according to the Bible, were the first people to visit Jesus? The good thing is I have loads of spare time to work on Friday's quiz. Question 15. In medicine, what J is the name given to the yellowing of the skin caused by the buildup of bile pigments in the blood? So what J is the name given to the yellowing of the skin caused by a buildup of bile pigments in the blood? Okay, sometimes refreshing the page works. I know, David, I'll have to think of a hobby in I've been sectioned off to the top floor because Amy's fine. Got it, Donna. It's the worst time, isn't it? Well, question 16. Which Disney character has a top made out of rubber and bottom made out of springs? I like that character. So which Disney character has a top made out of rubber and bottom made out of springs? Question 17. What's the most common colour of berries on a mistletoe bun? Because it was very... can't think of the word now. I didn't know there was other colours, basically, but there's one main colour. So what's the most common colour of berries on a mistletoe plant? Oh, thanks for cheering me up, everyone. And thanks for the lovely message, Heidi and Buffy's leotards. Thank you for that. Question 18, which car manufacturer has a model called the X-Trail? So which car manufacturer has a model called the X-Trail? In the lyrics of the song Santa Claus is Coming to Town, what is Santa Claus gonna find out? Are you still there, Jodie? What box was it in last night? So in the lyrics of the song Santa Claus is Coming to Town, what is Santa Claus gonna find out? So Anne, I'll miss you on Thursday. Is Laura there? Look for. Question 20. Pink Elephants on Parade is a song from which Disney film? Oh, any good, Martin? So, Pink Elephants on Parade is a song from which Disney film? Yeah, Laura. We played this this game for one of the quizzes, and we had 8 boxes, and in one of the boxes was 500 quid, so someone went away with 500 quid. Not bad, Martin. Question 21, which Friends actor, and you need the actor, appeared in the 1998 film Lost in Space. So which Friends actor appeared in the 98 film Lost in Space? Stop it, Debbie. Yeah, it was good, Debbie. I liked it, Jodie. I liked it, it was good. Question 22. In 2007, which fictional character appeared in a TV advert for Marmite where he tried a Marmite and cheese sandwich instead of a marmalade one? So which fictional character appeared in a TV advert for Marmite where he tried a Marmite and cheese sandwich instead of a marmalade one? Yeah, Michelle, you'll have to come one week. By the way, if you have just joined us, I'm just posting, again, that's the link for the entry form tonight where you put your answers in. Quiz lasts till about 9, and then at 10 o'clock, I go off and mark it for you. 23, you know, it's all right if it's you, isn't it? If you were born on Christmas Day, what star sign would you be? And there's a choice of four there. So if you were born on Christmas Day, what star sign would you be? Let's say just before we started the quiz. Amy went to the shop and look what she's got me, a big bag of chocolate and stuff. And strangely, because I can't get away from it, so if you get one of these questions, she put me that as well. So you know. Question 24, what frozen dessert brand has a name that means little horn in Italian? Everyone writing that down now. So what frozen dessert brand has a name that means little horn in Italian? I'm rubbish on star signs, Denise. I know mine. Question 25. Hi, if you're new, by the way. What's the name of the star that's symbolized on the flag of Israel? So what's the name of the star that's symbolized on the flag of Israel? Number 26, what V is the type of fortified wine mixed with gin to make a traditional martini? So what V is the type of fortified wine mixed with gin to make a traditional martini? Off the subject, has anyone tried, you know, that Apple Share thing where you can watch stuff together? That makes sense. Has anyone tried that? Because I sadly thought I could watch something with Amy. Question 27. The 1960 film La Dolce Vita was set in which European capital city? So La Dolce Vita was set in which European capital city? Worth a guess if you don't know that one. David knows what I mean, don't you, David? Now it's a maths question. If the diameter of a circle is 10 centimeters, what's its circumference rounded to the nearest centimeter? Now, I must stress, rounded to the nearest centimeter. You won't get the mark. No, it sounds weird if you get it exactly. Yeah, it's got to be rounded. Thanks, Debbie. Ooh, I sounded mean then, didn't I? I was going to get Grogu, but I won't because, Debbie, you're being nice to me. Thank you. Question 29. Oh, remember this. Which snooker player assisted Jim Davidson on Big Break? So which snooker player assisted Jim Davidson on Big Break? Turning my mobile off. Naughty Dave. And I've not forgotten, here is your anagram for tonight. So it is Yeah, David, I used to love that. That was the best bit, wasn't it? That's the only reason I watched it. Oh, I nearly said it then. I nearly, yeah, you know what I mean. It's three words. Oh, yes, well, we've got that. How'd you do that, Laura? So it's three words and it's food. And, you know, think Christmas as well. Now, what we'll do is we'll go through the first set of questions. Of course, as you know, if you played before, you can wind the video back on YouTube at any point. On Facebook, you have to wait until we finish at 9 o'clock. Then you can do it a few minutes later. But we always kind of recap the questions quickly for you. To save you doing that, hopefully. So 13, what does Cinderella's fairy godmother turn a pumpkin into? Some people write it down on pen and paper and then copy it across. Some people do it straight on the form. Who, according to the Bible, were the first people to visit Jesus? 15, what J is the name given to the yellowing of the skin caused by a buildup of bile pigments in the blood? Then, which Disney character has a top made out of rubber and bottom made out of springs? Question 17, what's the most common colour of berries on a mistletoe plant? And then, which manufacturer, Martin should get this one, has a model called the X-Trail? Question 19, in the lyrics of the song, Santa Claus is Coming to Town, what's Santa Claus gonna find out? And then 20, Pink Elephants on Parade is a song from which Disney film? Oh, Sean said got it first, yes. Nice one, Sean. Question 21, which Friends actor appeared in the 98 film Lost in Space? And 22, which fictional character appeared in a TV advert for Marmite where he tried a Marmite and cheese sandwich instead of a marmalade one? If you were born on Christmas Day, what star sign would you be? And then what frozen dessert brand has a name that means little horn in Italian? I'll have a look, Laura, later. What's the name of the star that's symbolized on the flag of Israel? And then what V is a type of fortified wine mixed with gin to make a traditional martini? The 1960 film La Dolce Vita was set in which European capital city? And then if the diameter of a circle is 10 centimeters, what's its circumference rounded to the nearest centimeter? So it'll be a whole number. Question 29, which snooker player assisted Jim Davidson on Big Break? I so nearly told you that. And then thanks, Jacksons, for your donation. And then anagram. I'm sure more people than Sean have got it. But it is a long one, this. And it's three words. Now then, as usual, set of catchphrases. But are you getting fed up with catchphrases? Should we leave them in? Should we do something different? Let us know in the comments. On the end of the form, that's up to you. It's your quiz. Set of catchphrases, and you can rewatch these because they're embedded inside your form. Here we go.
Here's a song everybody knows. Yeah, we all know how it goes. 'Cause it's the song everybody knows. So come on and sing.
Slim flam, noodle bottle, flip flop, beep bop, scruffle, ruffle, ding dang, willy wally, bing bang, tick tock, peekaboo, hippa dippa, doodle doo, fizzle dizzle, cling clang, noodle doodle, sing sang. Yeah, I said noodle doodle, sing sang.
He said noodle doodle, sing sang.
Here's a song everybody knows.
Song everybody.
Yeah, we all know how it goes.
All know how it goes.
'Cause it's the song everybody knows.
Song
so come on and sing. Come on and sing. Come on.
Flim flam, doodle bottle, flip flop, beep beep bop, scurfle,
scruffle-luffer, ding-dang, willy-wally, bing-bang, tick-tock, peek-a-boo, hippity-pa-toodle-doo, fizzle-dizzle-cling-clang, noodle-doodle-sing-sang, flim-flam, beetle-bottle, flip-flop, beep-bop, scruffle-luffer, ding-dang, willy-wally, bing-bang, tick-tock, peek-a-boo, hippity-pa-toodle-doo, fizzle-dizzle-cling-clang, noodle-doodle-sing-sang. Yeah, I said noodle-doodle-sing-sang.
Yeah, he said noodle-doodle-sing-sang.
Yeah, there's a song everybody knows.
There's a song.
A cling clang, noodle doodle sing sang. Yeah, I said noodle doodle sing sang.
He said noodle doodle sing sang.
Here's a song everybody knows.
Song everybody.
Yeah, we all know how it goes.
All know how
it goes. 'Cause it's the song.
Yeah, Debbie likes the ones that she knows. I must admit, I thought 31 was the. When you see the answers, it's easy, isn't it? You're like, oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, and Mark's. Mark's done well tonight. You like things that you can do, don't you? It's true. It's definitely true. Right, on to the music round. Just got one Christmas one in there. Ready for... I can't believe it's Friday. Can't. Denise is taking it back as well. So here we go. Five short clips, and I don't think we've got any lyrics with them tonight, but enjoy. Here we go.
Hey, hey, rock to the music. Rockin' every It's a beautiful night. We're looking for something dumb to do. It's a beautiful night. We're looking for something dumb to do.
How'd you do on them? Now, if you do need a recap, because we have a short break now for 10 minutes, I'm just posting again in the chat there. Laura, do you like them ones? I knew you'd like 36. I'm not that keen on 36. That's a recap for the music round, so you can replay that during the break or after the quiz if you like, if you missed one of them. A couple of short, aren't they? During the break, the questions that I've read out will appear, is it Debbie, on the screen on this side. Oh, my hand just going up there a little bit. And on this side, there's five bonus questions, if you like, which are on your form. It's basically saying... which country? It is. I don't know what's up with me tonight. Okay, back in 10 minutes. Please don't forget to make a small donation. Thank you for the people that already have. It's very much appreciated. After the break, we've got a round called sleep. And of course, some harder questions. And the wipeout round. See you in a little bit. David, you come out with all the good questions. I don't know. Okay, that is actually my favorite Christmas song. Oh, it's because it's three words, Lee, so it's a long one. Think, well, is it Christmassy? Yeah, kind of. So, 10 questions themed loosely around sleep. And we've only 4 days left. 4 sleeps. So, 46. Cheer up, Sleepy Jean is a line from which 1960s hit single. And you don't need, you know, you just need the name of the song on that. Oh, Martin's got the anagram. So, Cheer Up Sleepy Jean is a line from which 60s hit? Question 47, very recent survey. Asked British adults approximately how many hours of sleep they have per night on average. So what was the most common response? Was it 6 hours, 7 hours, or 8 hours? So in a survey, how many hours of sleep did most people say that they had per night on average? Was it 6 hours, 7 hours, or 8 hours? You're struggling tonight, Denise. But I'm not giving you a clue, Debbie. I'll get told off. Not done. In the Mr. Men books, who lives in Sleepyland? Where there's just 4 hours in a day. Oh, that sounds good. So in the Mr. Men books, who lives in Sleepyland where there's just 4 hours in a day? By the way, on the Christmas quiz, we're having a 10 question little movie round, you know, Home Alone and Die Hard, Denise, and stuff like that, you know, all the big ones. What Christmas films do you like? And we'll put some in, and we'll try not to, you know, go for the common ones that are banded about. Question 49, what do the letters REM stand for in the phase of sleep known as REM sleep? REM sleep, even. A clue, okay, the Z. The Z. Yes, Leah. Question 50, how is the condition of somnambulism better known? So how is the condition of somnambulism, that word, better known? Now then, I think this is hard, this one, but 51, in the Christmas song, my favourite one, One More Sleep, according to the lyrics, how many days until you're coming home? She says it a couple of times. So is it 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5? Oh, do you like Polar Express, Mark? Somnambulist. So according to the lyrics of the song, how many days until you're coming home? Leah, do you know what? I think that's my favourite one. Yeah, I think it is. Home Alone is obviously great. Question 52. Which British mattress and bed manufacturer shares its name with the Greek god of sleep? Keep putting them in because I'll look down this list later. So which British mattress and bed manufacturer shares its name with the Greek god of sleep? Get revising, Debbie. Home Alone. Here we go. According to the motto of Hogwarts in the Harry Potter novels, what should you never do to a sleeping dragon? Oh, Donna likes elf. So according to the motto of Hogwarts in the Harry Potter novels, what should you never do to a sleeping dragon? Yeah, Debbie, I mean, we all want to know what you think of it, because you can't not like that one. Question 54. I light a cigarette because I can't get no sleep. Is a line from which number one hit single? And again, you just need the name of the song for this. So I light a cigarette because I can't get no sleep. Is a line from which number one hit single? And last one of this bit, so 55. In a famous story by Washington Irving, who falls asleep for 20 years in the Catskill Mountains, causing him to miss the American Revolution? Martin, I've cut down. Anyway, going back through these one more time, I'll put them on screen. I won't say them for you, but you can, of course, wind back. So that was 46. Got to get the right name on that one, haven't you? 49, REM sleep. 55. So, we call these the harder ones. I mean, sometimes they are and sometimes they aren't. What we always do at the end of the quiz as well is at the bottom of the league table, if you've not noticed this before, we put the league table up and then we just put a couple of the questions that are most frequently, you know, answered incorrectly so you can, you know, compare. Right, so 56, where everything's done proper, and let's have a proper brew. Are slogans that have been used to advertise which brand of tea? So where everything's done proper and let's have a proper brew are slogans that have been used to advertise which brand of tea. '57 as a word, what's the 24th and last letter of the Greek alphabet? Staying out of it. So what's the last letter of the Greek alphabet? That's 57. '58. According to a survey by YouGov, we like these, don't we? We always put one of these in at least. What's the least favourite day of the week among British adults? What do you reckon? What's the least favourite day of the week among British adults? Question 59 in the computer-generated version of Christmas Carol, starring Jim Carrey as Scrooge, who plays the role of Bob Cratchit? So in the computer-generated Christmas Carol, starring Jim Carrey, who plays the role of Bob Cratchit? And then finally for this bit, sauna is a borrowed word from which one of those four languages? So sauna is a borrowed word from which language? So it's out of 70 tonight. So you're aiming for half, you're aiming for 35. So it's the last bit, it's the wipeout round. Now, if you've not played this before, it's a killer, this it is. When we have the league table later, if you do wipe out, there's a little W next to your name, and you do, pretty obviously, find that the bottom of the table is scattered with W's. Because basically, you lose all your points if you wipe out for this round. There's five questions, they're all worth double the points, 2 points each, but you can miss out the ones that you want, therefore not wiping out. Because they're all 50-50, it's that one or that one, or you can choose, no, I don't want to gamble, and you won't wipe out. Make sense? If you don't want to gamble, please make sure that you check that box, it's quite important that. I have, Lisa. I have. They're okay. Here we go. So 61. Would you find an epilogue at the start or at the end of a piece of writing? So you've either put in start, 2 points if you get it right, end, 2 points if you get it right, get it wrong, no points, or you're opting out. Hiya, Chris. 62 in the Lord of the Rings, of the 9 individuals who made up the Fellowship of the Ring, how many were hobbits? Was it 3 or 4? I think a lot of people are having a hard time at the moment, aren't they? Much love to you all. Question 63. Ofcom recently announced it had received over 600 complaints about an episode of This Morning from early in December in which Philip Schofield asked who if his dyslexia was the reason he broke COVID restrictions. Was it Matt Hancock or Boris Johnson? Yeah, David. So Ofcom recently announced it received over 600 complaints over what Philip Schofield said to who? Was it Matt Hancock or Boris Johnson? You've done well there, Anne. Really well. Two to go. What was the Mona Lisa painted on? Was it wood or canvas? I'm watching that series at the moment, or have been. Da Vinci's Demons. I think it's on Disney. It's quite good. Probably hence this question. So what was the Mona Lisa painted on? Was it wood or canvas? And last one tonight, gone quick, hasn't it? Is 65, who was recently named Time Magazine's Person of the Year for 2021? Was it Kamala Harris or Elon Musk? It's all a bit of fun, isn't it? So who was recently named Time Magazine's Person of the Year for 2021? And that's it. So if you've not done this before, what happens now? It's 9 o'clock now. You got till 10 to hit submit. So, you know, you can go back. If you wrote it on pen and paper, fill that form in now. Otherwise, puzzle over your answers a little bit more. And as soon as you're ready, press submit button. Then at 10 o'clock I mark it for you, and as soon as marking's complete, return a full set of answers by email to you. And of course the league table of scores as well. Hope you've had fun. I am that's the center of my universe at the moment. Friday Christmas Eve quiz. I'll really look forward to seeing you then. I will. Right, we'll go through these one more time. Please don't forget to make a small donation for playing. It's really very much appreciated. So 56. Thank you, Debbie. Thank you. Oh, thanks, Leah. Happy Christmas. Thanks, Elliot. There's 57 for you. Ooh, I wonder what people put for that. Thanks, Ian. Thanks for playing, mate. Yeah, David, thank you. Thanks for playing. Thanks for joining the chat as well. Question 60, sauna. Oh, thanks, Anne. Have a good time on Thursday. Let me know how it goes. It's still the same quiz it would have been on Thursday. Then it's Wipeout. Thanks, Denise. Ooh, who's that in Canada? Oh, thanks, Jan. Oh, thanks, Mark. Happy Christmas for Saturday. Thanks, Sean. Has anyone ever complained to Ofcom? Interesting. 64, Mona Lisa. Yeah, Mark, there's a few of us, isn't there? Yeah, I hope everyone does feel better soon. I do. And last one, 65. It's good that we can come on here, isn't it? Right, thanks very much. And I shall see a lot of you on Friday. And if not, have a great Christmas. Thank you, Chris. And thanks for playing. Hi, Jenny. See you later. Bye-bye.